Hi, I'm Serge Su, and welcome to Mac Studio A. This is part one of three screencasts from our Blueprint series. In part one, we'll be showing you how to create a Mac OS X USB boot disk. Then in part two, we'll be showing you how to create a Mac OS X system image file. And finally, in part three, we'll be putting it all together using parts one and two. So on to part one, creating a Mac OS X USB boot disk. Some reasons why you might need to create a boot disk might be that you might need to perform a clean install of Mountain Lion on a Mac Intel-based system. Or, alternatively, you might need to install Mountain Lion on another Intel-based Mac system or system that you might have. And finally, and my personal favorite, restoring a Mountain Lion system image file, and which we'll be demonstrating in part 3. Okay, let's get started. What you'll need: an Intel-based Mac system, an 8GB USB flash drive. Make sure to save all your data as it will be erased when the USB boot disk is created. And finally, a copy of OS X Mountain Lion. Check your applications folder to see if it's there. That's usually where it's downloaded to. You need the install file. Launch the Mac App Store and check your purchases tab to see if you've got one available to download. If not, you need to make a purchase. Whatever the case, you need a copy of OS X Mountain Lion to continue. As always, don't forget to make a backup of your hard drive or hard drives, just in case something goes wrong. As you know, human error prevails. So, assuming you've got a copy of Mountain Lion, navigate to its location, go to Finder, and go to the Applications folder. This is normally where the Mac App Store installs the Mac operating system or Mountain Lion. Right click on the icon and where it says Show Package Contents, click on that. Then double click on the Contents folder and finally double click on the Shared Support folder. What we're looking for is the installed ESD.dmg file. Next, we need to launch the disk utility program. Go to Launchpad, then in the other directory or folder, and click on Disk Utility. Once launched, we next need to insert our 8GB USB disk. Once done, go to the Disk Utility and make sure that your 8GB USB disk is selected. Click where it says Erase, then go down to the Erase button and confirm. The dialog box will come up, just click Erase. This will normally take 10 to 15 seconds. Once completed, we now need to partition the USB disk. Go to the Partitions tab and wait for a few seconds for that to load. Then, in the drop-down list, choose One Partition. Then click the Options button to make sure that the GUID partition table is selected. As this is an Intel-based Mac, it's done for you by default. Click OK to confirm, and then click Apply. And finally, click the Partition button to partition it. This again will take 10 to 15 seconds. Once completed, we need to restore or copy the Mac operating or Mountain Lion operating system onto the USB disk. Click on the Restore tab. Then make sure that the untitled one, what we just partitioned, is highlighted. Then remember the Shared Support folder we just opened earlier? Well, locate the installed ESD.dmg file and click and drag it to the source area of the Disk Utility window. Next, click and drag the untitled one to the destination location. Once done, click the restore button, then you will be prompted with a dialog box. Click erase, then you will be prompted to enter your admin and password details. Do so, and the Mac Mountain Lion operating system will be copied onto the USB disk. It indicated it will take 1 hour and 8 minutes, but in my case it only took 16 minutes. We'll now time lapse it by 8,000% so that you don't have to wait for the 16 minutes. Once completed, a dialog box or window will open up showing you the name of the USB disk and all its contents, which is Mac OS X Install ESD, as you can see here. Now all we need to do is just close all open windows and eject the USB disk. That takes care of part 1. Hope you join us in part 2 where we'll be showing you how to create a system image file. And finally, in part 3 we'll be putting it all together. As always, your feedback is important. If there's anything that you don't understand or you have a question, please leave them in the comments below. Until then, see you in part 2. Peace.